So what you'll have an opportunity to hear about today is refugee policy as it's experienced on the ground.
Welcome, thank you so much for coming on it. I know Saturdays are always a busy day.
Thank you for having me. And welcome everybody in Toronto.
Thank you.
My name is Resha. I am from Syria. I left Syria in 2010. I studied archaeology at Damascus University, and then I got the Fulbright scholarship and went to the States to do my master's degree. That was in 2010, and then the uprising in Syria started in 2011, and after that I couldn't go back to my country, and my focus was Syrian archaeology, and all the material I was studying, the ceramics, artifacts, they were in Syria, and I couldn't finish my master's degree because of that. I couldn't study, continue the analysis. So I had to switch my my analysis to a different side, different region. I came to Canada in 2012. I applied for a PhD, and I got accepted here at UFT. And it's now, I've been here for 5 years doing my PhD in Middle Eastern archaeology. So, being in this situation, being from Syria and not able to go back, I felt obligated. I felt I had to do something to at least, you know, help raise awareness, help my people back home or the people who already left. We used to do humanitarian work, send clothes, sometimes medicine to refugee camps like here in Toronto. But then it wasn't once a month, once every 2 months. But when the Canadian government decided that they wanted to accept Syrian refugees, many students at my department, because it's the Near and Middle Eastern Civilization Department. At my department, we study about Middle Eastern religion, Middle Eastern modern history, Middle Eastern languages, Middle Eastern archaeology. So we cannot move on in studying while the archaeological sites are being destroyed, you know, having a civil war, religions are fighting with each other, and pretend that, oh, nothing is happening back home, and like we are just studying. So this point, we wanted to do a student movement, like to involve students in the current conflict and politics. It's not like we should just focus on our study and forget what's happening around us. So this is how we were like, okay, if we are going to do something, it has to be a big thing. Like we wanted to involve all UFT department students. And this was in 2015, November 2015, when we knew the government is going to accept a large number of refugees. It was at the beginning, you know, that was our goal, and we were like, okay, let's see how it's going to be. And this is then when we started with a big event. We brought a scholar from Turkey, a Turkish scholar, to talk about the refugee situation, the Syrian refugee situation in Turkey. And then we had two professors from our university, one talking about the cultural destruction in Syria, Iraq, and other regions of the Middle East, and another professor talking about the political situation. It was a very well-attended event. We had more than 200 people coming, and the majority of the audience were undergraduate students, and they were very enthusiastic and very interesting. They came to us after, I was chairing that event and told the people that this is what we are, this is what we want to do. We want to start an initiative to help Syrian newcomers, and whoever is interested, please leave your email address, phone number. And then at the end, many people came to us, like the energy made us also more, we wanted to do it. This is, this time, here this one, we took them to the Toronto Island, I will just show you a photo when it was at the hotel. Sorry, I missed that photo. So in April 2016, so we started our initiatives, our workshops at the hotel in February 2016, and then we got funding from the University of Toronto, from the Art and Science, and then we were able to bring them to our university. So it was the first time for them moving the hotel area and coming to. So at the beginning it was hard because it was the first time for them. So sometimes we send them Ubers, like taxis, or to make sure they know the way. And then later, after they moved to their houses and left the hotel, then we showed them how to come to the university and all that. And so in April, we started our, in April 16, we started our workshops every Saturday at, you know, what is happening in Canada is very different, as you know, and comparing to what's happening now in the States and other regions in England, or it's very different here, and Syrians here are very lucky to be here. I am lucky to be here, and that my family is here now, because the community here is not just the government. It's not the government, it's the community. The Canadian community is amazing. Like, my family was sponsored by a temple and a mosque, a Jewish temple and a Muslim mosque, Canadian. So like, imagine like how beautiful this thing. So when people come here, Syrians, and see this this environment, this healthy environment, and how people are working so hard to make them feel welcome and make them feel included, they want to be part of this society, and they are trying hard to not to be open to this community, because they feel they are welcome, they feel they are included. Not like, if you compare it to other regions, for instance, in some areas in the States, they people, when they go there and feel that they aren't welcome, then they won't, they will be a closed community. And this is like, this is dangerous, also dangerous for younger kids. Like in some areas in France, for instance, there, because like some of the whatever they call terrorists, or like young people sometimes like did some bombing, and these people were isolated, so isolated, because they couldn't feel welcome or included in the French society. So this is why here I feel like initiatives such as the one we are doing here, and other initiatives like what the other Canadian communities are doing, so important, because then people won't be isolated and feel like hate, because hate then will create hate, right? So yeah, the more open the communities, the more people want to put in, the more they want to give back. Like now many Syrians, they want to give back to something, back to the Canadian community. This is why when they were teaching, they are happy, because they are like giving something back to Canadians, not just taking, you know. So this is something very important, to make them, give them a chance to give back, give them a chance to interact, you know, with the, like, this is why like sometimes, like when I had some media coverage when my family arrived, and like interviews and stuff, and one of the articles that was published, I had really nasty comments about like me and my family, after like it was on the Mail, Globe and Mail, and I was like upset that why would people be so hateful, so you know. But at the same time, I understand their position, that I shouldn't also be like, oh, you hateful, like you should be also mean to them. No, I should acknowledge them, I should talk to them and introduce them or educate them about Syrians, not just, you know, tell them bad things, or And then I, this is why I had another interview with the UFT News, and I was like telling that when refugees, when the war in Iraq in 2003 happened, we had many Iraqi refugees coming to Syria, a huge number. Like it was for at some point, I don't know, 500,000 just in one city in Damascus. And like I remember Iraqi refugees, because of them, I remember I was living in an apartment. I had to leave that apartment because there were many people that their prices increased, and an Iraqi person paid more than I pay, and I had to leave my apartment. So it was, we were like, oh, like we had already in Syria bad, and we had a bad infrastructure. So to add more to that refugees, so people were annoyed. Some people were annoyed by the Iraqi refugees. So we understand how people feel, you know, like, oh, these people are going to take our jobs, these people. But nobody could say no to them. Like, they are running from, you know, war, like killing. And so this is how, like, we've been through this situation. And when the Lebanese war happened, we had many Lebanese coming to Syria. We had many Armenians coming to Syria. Like Syria is a place to many refugees. Like it was and it has been. So this is why for us now being refugees, it's hard. But at the same time, we understand when people like feel this way toward us. But we should understand it, not like, you know, be like mean. Say something mean or be like, oh, you are hateful. No, we should educate them about the situation. Like, talk to, like, this is why Canadians or people who are racist or they feel, even sometimes I don't like to use the word racist, but like whoever, like they feel hate or something, like they should at least give a chance to the newcomers, give them a chance, talk to them, meet them first, and then judge or make your own opinion, but not make your opinion based on what you feel, like based on your experience, not on not based on what you heard.
Diversity within many kinds of backgrounds. Yeah, how do you call English?
What's it called?
Oh, it's good.
Oishi.
Oishi. Yummy.
How do you say delicious in Syrian?
I don't know either. Can you pop
up? I love
Yeah, I'm sorry.
인정하는
아이고